Welcome everyone. In the previous video, we saw the qualities of an inclusive teacher. It is pretty overwhelming to see the amount of efforts these teachers take. However, they can take help from the peers and other people in the school to help out with these students with disabilities. One such strategy is the circle of friends. This circle of friends strategy is used to increase the socialization of students with disabilities. Usually, the differently abled students or students with disabilities are neglected or even bullied by their peers. They don't experience friendships which typically developed students enjoy. This strategy consists of the focus child, who's the student with the disability, and potential friends who volunteer to help out the focus child by providing a support network. The circle of friends was developed by Forrest and Associates in North America when inclusion became accepted into the education system. It aims to create a supportive peer group. The group can consist of a combination of peers, teachers, and parents too. The circle of friends is a successful strategy helping students with disabilities, especially students with autism spectrum disorder who find it difficult to communicate and make friends. So let us try and understand the process of the circle of friends strategy. The strategy may be conducted by a teacher or a facilitator. Once the focus child or student requiring the strategy is identified, certain prerequisites are required before beginning with the meetings. These include formal permission from the school personnel, like the principal and staff, permission and cooperation from the parents of the focus child, even from the caregivers like nurses, therapists, and doctors treating the focus child needs to cooperate in this process. And finally, the focus child too needs to agree to undergo the process. Once these formalities are done, then a meeting is scheduled with a group which consists of peers or in some cases, teachers too. But it is done in the absence of the focus child. This is done so that it is not awkward for the focus child and the potential friends can openly discuss the problems faced by the focus child during the meeting. Next, the peers or the members of the group are asked to draw four concentric circles. Each member could draw, or one volunteer who is a typically developed child is asked to draw. The child drawing writes their name, or in the center of the circles writes me. The innermost circle represents the closest person or persons like family members. The next circle includes best friend or friends, but not as close as in circle number one. The third circle denotes the wider friend or friends like neighbors or members of a sports team or any group that the child is involved in co-curricular or extracurricular activities in the school. Finally, the outer circle consists of people who are paid for help. Now, let's see a sample of a circle of friends drawing done by a typically developed student. Wow, so many people in the student's life. Imagine how happy the student must have felt to see so many people interacting with him or her. Notice the student has included a pet dog in the inner circle along with the immediate family members, along with mom and dad. I found that really cute. There are uncles and aunts included in the second circle with best friends. The third circle has a librarian and a coach along with neighborhood friends. Finally, the outermost circle has doctors and shopkeepers who are there along with people who are paid to help the student. The members are now asked to draw a similar diagram, imagining that they are the focus child. Remember, this activity is being done in the absence of the focus child. Another thing to be noted is that all the members have interacted with the focus child and have some idea of his or her social circle. So let's see one such diagram. Immediately the difference can be seen. There is a sudden awareness that emerges among the members about the small number of people shown in the diagram. I am sure you can see the differences too. This follows a discussion about the differences and a comparison between the two diagrams. Here, you can see in the inner circle, there's not much difference as it consists of family members. This difference starts showing from the second circle onwards. You can see that the number of close friends drastically decreases for the focus child. There's only one person for the focus child as against 9 for the typically developed child. The third circle has no individuals for the focus child as he may not be participating in any of the extracurricular activities in the school or may not have any neighborhood friends. However, for the other child, there are so many people. In the last circle, the number increases in the focus child's diagram when compared to his previous circles. This is because differently abled children have to depend on professionals as paid help. In all the three circles, the members of the friends is very few for the focus child. Members are encouraged to discuss what are the hurdles the focus child faces while making friends. It is again important to note that in this meeting, along with the peers, parents may also be included and they have a clear idea about the social circle of the focus child. This is where the facilitator selects 6 to 8 volunteers who show empathy and willingness to help the focus child in making friends and improving his social circle. The facilitator may also be a teacher who's trained in the process and the strategy of circle of friends. Right. So now let's do a recap of the process so far. So the circle of friends starts with gaining permission from the school, family, and the focus child. This is followed by a meeting with the potential friends who do the circle of friends activity diagram, which we saw samples of previously. It is through this activity that volunteers are identified who become the support group for the focus child. In this activity, as we have seen earlier, that the child is not present. This follows an initial meeting, and here this is done in the presence of the focused child. This meeting is conducted within a week's time of identifying the volunteers. Here, detailed discussion is done regarding the ground rules to be followed while discussing the meetings, and assurance to the focused child is given that anything discussed will be kept confidential. Next, a detailed discussion is conducted regarding the observed strengths of the focused child. This is a welcome change for the focused child because here the peers appreciate and accept the focused child. And here it is something which is really different for the focused child, because instead of people telling him his limitations and things that he cannot do, here people are talking about his strengths and the things that he can do. Such a discussion helps the focused child increase confidence. The child is then asked to share the hurdles faced during social interaction. The group members then discuss and give suggestions to the child to overcome the hurdles. Goals are set for the focused child to be achieved. In a similar fashion, weekly meetings are conducted to discuss the observed behavior, which most of the time emphasis is laid on the strengths. What are the positive behavior which the child has shown? Then again, the hurdles faced by the child, along with solutions or suggestions given by members, and also how far the goals have been accomplished by the focused child. These interactions with time help develop a close friendship and bond between the focused child and the group members, which is a very positive one. And this results in a fun-filled experience for all. The circle of friends strategy has frequently been successful in helping children with disabilities improve their social skills. Research shows that circle of friends has not only proved to be beneficial for the focused child, but also for the peers in the circle. The drawing made by the typically developed students, they help them to appreciate the people who care and are there to support them. It also helps them to develop empathy when they prepare and then compare their drawings with those of the focused child, because they have to put themselves in the shoes of the focused child while preparing their drawings. This is an emotional experience consisting of learning and fun all in one. These are the references for more information. I hope this video has been able to clarify the circle of friends strategy. Thank you for watching the video.